Back into the labyrinth. We'll do one more run today. Need the slime goo for possible vellum. See if I can get the stuff together on this run. The problem with like now the inventory limitations work in this is it makes it really hard if you want to craft a particular vellum to get the ingredients together. Because you can't just go, oh, I need these ingredients, I'm going to stuff them in a chest at the inn until I get the ingredients to make with what I want to make. Okay, I think this is related to the phases of the moon, now that I think about it. Look at the moon phase at the bottom of the screen, it's a new moon. Crap. There we go. Like, I could use those components, but I'd just rather get out of the situation as soon as possible. Alright. Thank you. Alright. Action. Oh, cancel. And then like, I will say that this is, I definitely feel like this game could learn something from Earthbound, particularly in terms of the, you are spectacularly overleveled, monsters of this at certain dungeon levels will just, or XP levels, will just learn their lesson and leave you alone. Like, it's the smart, like, the way this should pan out is maybe the ninja will stick around, but here, like, the goblin's like, nope, we're done. Like, if you outnumber the amount of enemies and can take them all out in a rush, the correct, like, the option here should be enemy use, response to your action should be enemy uses, just runs away immediately. I mean, mindless undead, that's an entirely another matter. Thank you. Alright, back to B4. So there's a spot I need to get to in this dungeon for one of the side quests. Teleporter over here. Oh, grab this first. Granted, just enough poison in the last dungeon, like on level 3, that you know what? I'm fine with. Here we go, undead. Yep, and they sneak attack me, because of course they do. And dispel the kobolds. I need to get the magic katana, or a magic katana. There we go. Alright, okay. So I know where I need to get to. Thank you. down there.
Okay.
Story trigger. There. In a labyrinth full of tombstones, a man stood absentmindedly. He was not doing anything in particular, just staring at the grave before him. All that's left here is the grave and body of someone rotting away. I thought I fully understood that. He had shoulder-length black hair and almond-shaped eyes. The man in front of you fit the description of Giorgio, whom you were asked to find. I guess somewhere in my heart, I believe, however illogical, is it possible for somebody left it here and be gone. I probably believe that there is nothing that couldn't be undone in this world. I get back to whatever I lost. Up until the time I lost someone dear to me. The man must have felt something. After identifying himself, he quietly began talking about his past. The man was Giorgio Avello. He killed people for money. His existence was only known to a handful of the population. All the work he did was always shrouded in bloody darkness. Never meant for anyone to know about. When the flash happened, I had just finished a job and was on my way back to town. I saw the flash. The only thought in my head was that of her, and I hoped and prayed that she was still alive. Then at least could apologize her for the heartless things I'd done to her. All the terrible things I've ever said to her. Is it funny, after I murdered so many people? But all that was left for me was her tragically charred dead body. That was the response to my prayers. The time has never moved for me since. Giorgio gently touched the gravestone once more before he left. He faded away, blending in with the somber scenery. A beautiful ring sat upon the grave. On the ring, with the name Rose Avelio was engraved. You got a promise ring! Rose's quest has been completed. Go to the tavern to get your reward. Okay. Okay, come back over here for another side quest. Over there's a pit trap. Trap there. Pretty obviously marked pit trap there.
Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the show, please like and subscribe. And also consider backing my Patreon. Patreon backers get episodes up to 1 week early of this show and any future Let's Plays. Also, please consider backing my coffee. Toss me a few bucks, also helps support the show, and it's not a monthly obligation or anything like that.